إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. ثم أما بعد، قيل إذا لم تستطع أن تسمع صمت أخيك فإنك لن تستطيع أن تسمع كلامه. It was said that if you are unable to listen to the silence of your brother, you will not be able to listen to his words. A story that will explain the meaning of this saying. رجل عالم صاحب بصيرة وخلق كان جالسا مع تلاميذه، فدخل عليه الرجل غريب لا يعرفونه، فجلس إلى ما انتهى إليه المجلس واستمع بأدب ووقار، وكان بيده قارورة، قارورة ماء لا تكاد تفارقه، يعني متمسك بها. A scholar who has manners and deep insight in knowledge and firasa was sitting with his students when a stranger just walked in. No one knows him. He appears to be someone who is dignified yet humiliated somehow, or someone was honored or rich and things changed in his life, now he is in need. So he kept walking and he sat where he found the closest seat, and he was listening with respect and adab and everything. And he has like a bottle, it has water in it or something that looks like water. It's constantly in his hand and he's kind of, you could say, playing with it, but yani, so proud of it. فقال العالم يعني أوقف الدرس. The scholar stopped the lecture and he said, ألك حاجة نقضيها أم سؤالا نجيبك عليه؟ Do you have a need that we can fulfill for you or a question that we can answer? فقال لا، ليس لي حاجة وليس عندي سؤال، بل أنا تاجر، جئتك لأبيعك هذه القارورة، سمعت عن علمك ومرؤتك وخلقك وأنت حقيقة يعني كما سمعت. He said, no, I don't have a question, I'm not in need for anything, I'm a businessman. I came to sell you this bottle with what's in it. I heard about your knowledge and I heard about your manners and etiquettes, and subhanAllah, you exactly fit. ولا أريد أن أبيعها إلا لمن يعرف قيمتها وأنت جدير بذلك. He said, I'm not going to sell this but to someone who can really value what's in it and appreciate it, and you qualify for that. فقال العالم هات أنظر إليها، أعطني أنظر إليها، let me have it to look at it. نظر إلى الرجل ببصيرته ونظر إلى القارورة وأصبح يهز برأسه، أي يعني مقيما لهذه القارورة. He looked at the man with deep insight And he looked at the bottle the same way, and he started nodding his head in agreement with the value of what's in that bottle. Then he looked up, نظر إليه وقال كم تريد أن تبيعه. How much the price you're asking? قال 100 دينار. قال أنا أعطيك 150. هذه تستحق أكثر من ذلك. He looked at it and he said $100. So the scholar looked at it and he said, I'll give you 150. It deserves more than that. قال لا لا أزيد ولا أنقص هي 100 دينار. He told him, no, I don't want more or less. Just exactly $100 dinar. قال لابنه اذهب وأت بمئة دينار من أمك. فذهب وأتى بالمئة أعطاه المئة وأخذ القارورة وذهب الرجل وانفض الطلاب وذهب إلى النوم. So he told him, go get 100 dinar from your mom. He brought the 100 dinar, he gave it to him, he took the bottle, and everyone left, and he went to sleep. وكل الطلاب متعجبون من هذه القارورة أو هذا الماء بمئة دينار. All the students went home puzzled. Paid 100 dinar for what appears to be water. So he went to sleep. في الليل الولد يعني بدي يشوف شو هالقارورة. At night, his son, he said, I want to go check it out, see what's in it. So he looked and he inspected and he came with conclusion there's nothing in there but real water. ذهب إلى والده وقال والله يعني ما أعرف أستغرب من ذكاء وخبث هذا التاجر أم من طيبة قلبك وتسرعك في الشراء. ليس في هذه القارورة إلا ماء. The son looked at his dad and he said, Dad, you are the wise of the wise. You're so, mashallah, knowledgeable, but I'm really confused. I don't know how puzzled I am from how intelligent and how deceitful that man is, or how kind and how quick you are to really pay such a price for something this cheap. نظر إليه أبوه وقال يا بني أنت نظرت إلى القارورة ببصرك وأنا نظرت إليها ببصيرتي. أنت لم تر ببصرك إلا ماء وأنا رأيت ببصيرتي أن هذا الرجل أتى ولا يريد إلا حاجته. أتى بماء وجهه في هذه القارورة ولا يريد أن يذل نفسه بسؤال. فأتى وطلب ما طلب. وأحمد الله سبحانه وتعالى أن الله وفقني لفهم حاجته. ووالله لو دفعت بها الآلاف لما ندمت، ولو أني حلفت على ذلك لما حنفت. He told him, son, let me explain this. You looked at the bottle with your vision, plain vision. You saw water. I looked at the bottle when I looked at the man with my deep insight, the firasa, which is light that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts in the heart of the believers. And I saw a man who has been dignified and honored before. Now he's badly in need for 100 dinar, only 100 dinar. And he doesn't want to humiliate himself by asking donation or someone to give him that money. So he came with that bottle, hoping that someone will understand or will get without asking. And I praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He granted me the basira and I fulfilled His need. And I swear, son, by Allah, if I pay thousands for that bottle, I don't have to expiate for my swear, meaning I said the truth. And this is exactly, brothers, the meaning of if you cannot listen to the silence of your brother, you're not going to be able to listen to his words. Meaning, if you really have someone, a friend, and you really understand what friendship is, or a relative, and so forth, you would understand their need without them asking. And really, this is in the Quran, Surah Al-Baqarah. This is talking about the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, who are the best of the most dignified from asking. When they migrated from Mecca to Medina, what did they have? Nothing. But did they go there and start begging? We know the stories. When Abdul Rahman ibn Auf was offered half of the wealth of Sa'd ibn Rabi' radiallahu anhu, he told him, may Allah bless you and bless your family. Show me where the market is. I can work, I can earn. So this ayah, it says, لِلْفُقَرَاءِ الَّذِينَ أُحْصِرُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ لَا يَسْتَطِيعُونَ ضَرْبًا فِي الْأَرْضِ يَحْسَبُهُمُ الْجَاهِلُ أَغْنِيَاءَ مِنَ التَّعَفُّفِ تَعْرِفُهُمْ بِسِيمَاهُمْ لَا يَسْأَلُونَ النَّاسَ إِلْحَافًا. Referring to the companions radiallahu anhum, they are in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala migrating. They cannot work, they don't have anything to do. They appear for the ignorant that they are rich. But for those who really know them, they can tell that they are in need. They appear rich because they don't ask. But for those who know, they don't have to ask. So if you can come to your brother, you know you have a brother, you basically know him, and you know what he has, and his work and all that. He has an accident, or operation, or something. He doesn't have to come and tell you, I need your help. He doesn't have to tell you, brother, oh, the operation costs this much and this much. If you're truly a brother, you save him the hassle and the humiliation of begging and asking. You come and you advance. And he said, I know what happened, brother. Here is support for you. You may need it, you may not, but don't worry about it. Whenever you can, you pay me back. That is the true brotherhood. That is the true brotherhood, is to know your brother's need before he asks you, simply because you know your brother. We're not just here to know that I pray next to you, or I talk to you, or I cross the path with you. We should really know each other and know the need. And when someone disappears, for instance, if he doesn't come to prayer, why he didn't come to pray? What happens to him? Where is he at? Let's check on him. Let's ask him. Unfortunately, I'm saying that, and I know this is hard to accomplish, but this is what it requires. Most of the dedicated people who come to this masjid and pray, الناس كلها تقريبا بتصلي يعني يوميا بجانب رجل أو بجانب آخر يوميا ولا يعرف لا الرجل ولا اسمه ولا حاجة ولا شيء. Most of us come and pray next to each other and we don't know anything about each other. And we talk about brotherhood all the time. How can I help the brother if I don't know his name, or I don't know where he's at, and I don't know what he works, and don't talk to him, don't converse with him, just Allahu Akbar, Assalamu Alaikum, Assalamu Alaikum, bye. Is this how we're gonna, we can give all speeches and we can recommend and read hadith and Quran. The reality of life, the practicality of life is missing. We talk and we do things, but show me. I need to know him, you need to know me, I need to know him, and all one of us, especially the one who come all the time. If you every day introduce yourself to a brother, eventually it becomes easy to know one another. But now a person dies, Allah, he literally dies, and he's constant in here, and you don't even miss him, you don't even know what happened to him. Why? Because it seems like we're so preoccupied with ourselves and our prayers, not with our brotherhood. Because I don't even know how we can go to Jannah If we don't have that relationship with one another, we know the ahadith that a woman was so bad to her neighbor, or not good to her neighbor, but she prays and she does qiyam and fast and everything. Prophet ﷺ said, she's going to hell, because relationship is practicality. We have two relationships in our life. One with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and one with people. Both of them have to be right. تتمثل علاقتنا مع الله سبحانه وتعالى في العبادة وتتمثل علاقتنا مع الناس في الإحسان. Your relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we know it. Worship, fast, pray, zakah, hajj, and all of that. But when it talks about people, ihsan, ihsan is to be muhsin, to be good, to be there, to be kind, to be friendly, to be social, sociable, all of those things. So let's know ourselves before someone come and beg you and humiliate himself and ask you for this like some people do. You go humiliate yourself and your need is $100 and you give him $1. So he needs to humiliate himself for another 99 people before he can get his accomplished need. Yeah, we know all of the needs and we know what people do, but when you know the person, he doesn't have to come like that. And we know people are not trusted nowadays, unfortunately. And we know people when they want it, many of them, they may get the money and not give it back. But we're talking about people you know. We're talking about people you meet. And when you give for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not hoping even for it to come back. Imagine, every day passes when you know someone in need, it's like giving charity for the same amount for that person. It's amazing. It's amazing how much reward you get for that. Instead of donating, look for someone who is in need and help him. For something like that, you give the donation multiplied many times. So all the time, when you give with no expectation that you're going to get it back. If you got it back, alhamdulillah. If you don't, you're already doing the good. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us all the time, put our learning and our knowledge in practice, and make us, inshallah, work for our brotherhood, meet one another, and inshallah, you will be there for your brother, and your brother will be there for you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fi awni al-abd, ma kana al-abd fi awni akhih. Jazakum Allahu khayran, subhanak Allahumma wa bihamdika, ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.